Were Neanderthals fully human? Welcome to Creation Basics, where our goal is to make God's creation part of your everyday conversation. Now, today's episode, we're continuing a series featuring number 9 of 10 different instances where evolutionists have changed position on a major concept that's part of the creation-evolution controversy towards more of a creationist viewpoint. I've been saying since the beginning of our series, you know, understand, they haven't switched to believe in biblical creation. I'm just doing this series to highlight to people that science is revealing that creationist interpretations of the facts that we see in God's world are better understood according to God's word. It's a better explanation of the facts. Now, today's question, were Neanderthals fully human? Obviously, what evolutionists and biblical creationists believe about where man came from is completely different. Evolutionists hold to the idea that man isn't really special, other than we're more sophisticated, kind of the end result of an animal that's descended from a long line of ape-like creatures and so on. So the concept that man was created in the image of God, distinct from the animals and the rest of God's creation, is in total opposition to the materialistic view. Now, over the years, evolutionists have proposed several supposed primitive ancestors to humans using certain fossils in support of their claims. Several versions of this have been produced, and you've probably remember seeing pictures or displays at museums showing a long line of skulls showing up what evolutionists believe were part of our, ancient ancestral lineage. Now, as biblical creationists, we'd say there are only 3 ways to make an ape man, okay? One is to make an ape more human-like. 2 would be to make a human more ape-like, and 3 would be to fraudulently mix the two together. So we've maintained that these fossils are either the remains of apes or humans, not some evolutionary intermediary between the two. And of course, one of the most popular and well-known supposed primitive subhumans was supposedly Neanderthal man. Now, to young Earth creationists, Neanderthals are not that mysterious. We view the Neanderthals as fully human ancestors of some people today, probably some Europeans and Western Asians, where the Neanderthals lived. Hence, we creationists would refer to them as Homo sapiens sapiens or Homo sapiens Neanderthalis. Either way, we believe that they would be fully capable of reproducing with modern humans if they were living today. They were a post-flood Ice Age people group. But from their earliest evolutionary depictions, they were shown as only somewhat human and not very intelligent, kind of primitive looking and almost deformed, with many evolutionary scientists believing Neanderthals were, quote, lacking the language skills, foresight, creativity, and other cognitive abilities of modern humans. I mean, I remember seeing pictures of them like that just like that in my textbooks. You know, they're often dragging a club behind them, walking out of some cave. And this depiction is still popular in museums and textbooks and movies and TV commercials to this day. I mean, some of you probably remember the Geico commercial a few years ago with the slogan, "So easy, a caveman can do it." And then later on in the commercials, they showed the cavemen were offended because they were actually smart and they thought the commercials were so stereotypical. They were pretty funny. Well, that's kind of what's happened to the Neanderthal myth. Modern science has revealed the truth. Do you know it's been discovered that Neanderthals made up and used makeup and stored it in decorative shells? I mean, how many people do you know today that would have the knowledge or the time or, to study and go look for and experiment with all the various compounds needed to put makeup together? You know, the evidence that Neanderthals lacked nothing that present-day humans do is actually overwhelming now. And the modern depictions of them in evolutionary magazines like National Geographic appear fully human. Even the variances in body structure fall within the normal range of humans. You see, now we know that they had speech ability and they actually had bigger brains than modern humans. They painted exquisite artwork. They made musical instruments. They buried their dead in religious ceremonies. They made high-tech super glue. They used sophisticated tools and weapons, and they thought in symbolic terms, and they used portable light sources to navigate in deep caves, and they even had medical knowledge. And to top it all off, some evolutionists agree that DNA studies have shown it's likely Neanderthals bred with modern humans, meaning if they did, they themselves must have been fully human. And that was our question today. Were Neanderthals fully human? Well, once again, the honest evolutionist must concede that the creationist position based on the Word of God was the correct one all along. Hey folks, Calvin here. If you've been watching this program for a while now, have been blessed by the content, understand the importance of biblical authority, and have the means, please consider giving a one-time gift or becoming one of our monthly supporters by clicking that link below. And even if you don't, keep watching. Our goal is to equip the average believer to be able to share the gospel more frequently and effectively by making God's creation part of your everyday conversation. Stay blessed.